If you're going to take on a side hustle to complement your normal day job, it's often handy to do something you're already familiar with.
Dr. Judy Melinik has nailed it. By day, she does autopsies, and by night, she writes crime novels with her husband, TJ. It's no surprise that the morgue is a great source of inspiration. Julian Lee reports.
Surprisingly few Wellingtonians know about this place, the Fever Hospital in Newtown, built to house the infected during the 1918 Spanish flu pandemic. It's also the site of one of the only morgues in the city that we could get access to, thanks to the SPCA, who in a weird twist of fate now run their headquarters out of here.
My name is Dr. Judy Melinik. I'm a forensic pathologist in the Wellington Mortuary.
And my name is TJ Mitchell. I'm a crime novelist.
Great. And well, and you're also sort of a crime novelist. Well, you are a crime novelist.
We write together, yes.
During the day, Judy deals with the city's dead. She works out how they died.
I feel that my role is to give closure to the families of the deceased.
Just having to work right down there, right?
I work right down there at the hospital, yeah, at Wellington Hospital.
I got a question because I used to freak out my sister, Steph, when we were driving past Middlemore Hospital when we were kids. And I used to tell her that the chimneys are where they burn it with people.
No,
is it?
Oh, no, is it I don't not? Think so.
And at night, like some kind of literary superhero.
He works on them during the day while I'm doing autopsies. And then when I come home at the end of the day, he's preparing dinner. And usually I sit at the kitchen table and I will read to him whatever he's written that day. And if I have any feedback, I'll put it in right there.
The two put together a New York Times bestseller, their first book, Working Stiff, non-fiction, based on Judy's training in New York.
Dr. Judy Melinik is about to add to her already impressive dead body of work.
Hit forensic shows like ER have actually called Judy up before to see if they got it right.
On television, there'll be a forensic show like CSI or Bones or one of those shows, and I just end up yelling at the television or throwing things because they're always telescoping time, they're inventing tests that don't exist, they get the time of death down to the minute when we can't really be that accurate. We're usually in the ballpark of
a few hours. Detectives run, or not the detectives, but the medical examiner running around with a gun or something.
Yeah. You know. Interrogating people, yeah. We don't do that.
And now, fiction. Works of fancy.
These are noir detective novels in the American tradition, so we take plenty of creative liberty, but the science is always real.
Usually I come up with a plot arc or idea, and then we go for walks.
Yeah.
We walk in Zealandia or up, you know, up in the hills around Wellington and the City to Sea walkway,
right.
And that's when we formulate our plots.
Yeah, so if you're out in the Greenbelt hearing two Yanks talk about murdering someone, just check, it's probably
it's
us.
Probably us.
Everything's probably
Yeah, you don't
fine.
Have to call the police.
In real life, the scariest things are the most mundane. Heart disease, car accidents.
The things that are going to kill you are mostly predictable, and the things that aren't predictable, you can't do anything about it.
Exactly, so it's actually very freeing. It gives you kind of a carpe diem kind of attitude of life, and I find that working with death every day makes me much more appreciative of every moment I have on this earth and every moment I have with my family.
It'd be a lot less interesting here, surely, than working in San Francisco. There's all sorts of weird stuff that happens over there, right?
Well, there's weird stuff that happens here, too. In fact, we're currently working on a novel based here in New Zealand. It's based in Wellington. Our working title is She'll Be Right, to some degree based on the fact that Kiwis have a tendency to use that phrase when everything's going to be okay, and maybe it might not
maybe
be.
It isn't.
It's a wonderful place to build a mystery.
For in the hills above Wellington, there is a mysterious malignancy. And a story just waiting to be told.